friends. This is Joy. So I decided to do this animal, and I drew it ahead of time so you didn't have to watch that whole thing. I actually just kind of drew it the night before while I was sitting on the couch watching TV. And so here I'm using my kneaded eraser, as usual, to try to remove as much of the pencil as I can, but still be able to see the animal. And then I'm using my trusty old water brush. You know, I really should grab some of my watercolor brushes that I paid good money for. But this is, this water brush came in this watercolor kit. So I just keep opening it up and grabbing that and using it. So far, so good, but I know that if I used a proper watercolor brush, I might avoid some of the frustrations that I, you know, have when doing watercolor. So here I realized I kind of came down a little too far into an area that's supposed to be white, but I figure, well, I'll deal with that and fix it later. So I'm just trying to block in the animal here, the main color of the animal, and, you know, trying to add lighter areas and darker areas where I see those. After I finished this painting of this animal, I had to go online to try to figure out what exactly it was called, because I didn't know. And I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce it, but I'm hoping I'm pronouncing it right. I found out it was a kudu type antelope. It's a type of an antelope called a kudu, whatever that, if that's how you pronounce that. Hopefully I pronounced it correctly. So I really like, you know, the way that this turned out. I was really pleased with it when I was done. I did take quite a bit of time and effort to, you know, do this, and it took me, gosh, just to paint this over an hour. So I did try to, you know, speed up and reduce the video so that, you know, you didn't have to sit through such, you know, a long video. So I reduced it as much as I could. And here in some of these areas, like the one I just did, I put down the color, and then I just grabbed some water on my brush and then, you know, faded it out. And here, underneath his neck there, I was having some trouble trying to figure out, you know, what was going on. I was trying to put lights and darks where I saw them in the picture, but it wasn't making a lot of sense to me. And when I went online to find out what this animal was called so I could properly name it, I saw that they have like this like kind of hair type mane that hangs underneath, you know, their neck there. And so I did go back in, you'll see towards the end, and try to add that in, because by the time I was done with this, I finally gave up and just kind of smoothed everything out, because I thought, well, maybe it's just light and shadows from, you know, whatever was around the animal when the picture was taken and whatnot. But no, come to find out there's actually like a mane or a beard, or I don't know what you call it, that runs down, you know, the bottom of the front of this animal, including down its back, which I do get that in, and you'll see that. And of course you'll see here, like here, a couple places I ended up getting paint in areas I didn't want it. So I was like, well, I will probably have to put a background on this animal when I'm done with it. But I didn't. I decided not to at the end, and I actually just used a white Posca pen to kind of, fix those areas where I, messed up the background. I don't know. I mean, I guess I could put some color in the background behind these animals, but by the time I get done painting the animal, and especially if I take a good amount of time like I did on this one, I'm usually like, okay, I'm done. I just don't feel like, I guess, messing with it anymore. But, I don't know. I don't know if it will help kind of bring it, the animal out, or maybe make the animal like not stand out as much, I guess, is what I'm thinking. But in any case, I haven't really gotten to that point. I just am enjoying the process of drawing and then, painting these animals. And so then, when I got to the horns now, I was a little bit intimidated, I have to say. I've never painted horns. I wasn't sure how I was going to go about painting the horns or approaching, this part of the animal. But I'm gonna just give it my best shot and hope for the best. And I guess, I went over them a couple of times and struggled with them a bit. And I guess in the end, I was happy with them. I mean, I'm sure other artists that are more experienced than myself might look at it and think, oh, well, that's not really that good of a job, or, I could have, maybe done better or done something different, but since it's my first time of ever painting horns like this and being new to using watercolors, I think I did a pretty good job. So I did, like I said, go over them several times and fussed with them a bit until I was at least, for the most part, satisfied with how they looked. And so, yeah, like I said, I thought they turned out pretty good in the end. I did the best I could with trying to make them, look, I guess, like they were supposed to, or like they should, or at least close or similar. I did, and I wasn't expecting to, in the end, go over the animal with colored pencils. But I did decide to, in the end, to go over it with colored pencils, because I just, well, first of all, like when I finished this, when I was done doing my watercolor painting of the animal, I grabbed, the white jelly roll to go add in some highlights and things, and it just wasn't doing it for me. And so then I thought, well, let me try using, because I've seen where people will use like a white colored pencil over their watercolor. So I thought, well, let me grab, my colored pencils and maybe try using the white of the colored pencils and see how that works, which actually it worked very well. I was really happy with the way that worked. I've never done that before. And then I just kind of got into using some of the other colored pencils to add more depth and detail to the animal, which you'll see that towards the end, which is again another reason why I guess I'd spent so much time on this animal, was adding, once I got to that point where I was trying to deepen the color and adding more to it with the colored pencils, you kind of just get into a flow, and then you know, I mean, I could have sat and fussed with it for much longer, but I finally got to a point where I was like, you know what, it's good, it looks good, I'm happy with it, I think we just need to call it done. And so I did finally quit fussing with it, decided to call it done, and was, like I said, very pleased and very happy with the way it turned out. The only area, I guess, that I wasn't completely happy with was his ears, the way his ears turned out. In particular, the inside of the ears. I had some trouble and some struggles with that. But, like I said, in the end, I was like, you know, well, it is what it is. So here I'm just trying to add very, very light, a bit of that brown, but as light as I could get it, as watered down as I could get it, because, you know, even in the white, on the white areas of the animal, there, it's not going to be completely, you know, white. So yeah, here's where I was fussing with the inside of the ears, trying to get them to look right. And I don't know that I ever did get them to look right. I just ended up giving up on that. So this was another area where I was like, not completely happy, but I was like, you know what, good enough. I went over both of them several times and still was not completely happy. But again, yeah, decided that, you know, it is what it is, and I'm done fussing with it, and just decided to leave it as it is. So I go in here and add in the darker areas, like his, with his mouth, his nose, and his eyes. And I don't make his eyes on there. I'm just trying to lift up some of that to add the highlight to the top of the nose. I don't make his eyes as dark as I wanted them with the watercolor, but I went ahead and put them in, and then I'm like, you know what, I don't need to worry about that so much, because I can do that with, you know, when I'm done with the watercolor part with like a black pen, you know, I can go in with a black pen when I go to do that, like I've been doing with my animals, using a black pen to add some deeper values, and using a white jelly roll to add highlights and stuff. I can finish the eyes out when I get to that point. So here I'm, you know, feeling like I'm getting pretty close to being done with this. And I see a few more details on here that I wanted to add and include. You know, fixing to dry it, and then I'm like, oh, well, there's a few things here, and then I forgot about the mane on his back that I needed to put in. So, with the watercolors, so I went back and, you know, and put that in so that that would be in watercolor, and then I could, again, add more detail with a white and a black pen, you know, after I'm done with the watercolor part, and I get this all dried out. So that's what I'm doing here. It's just getting that mane that's on his back. So yeah, at points I was trying to like zoom in on areas to try to see better, and that helps. And I tried to zoom in on the area around his neck, but again, the picture was not really, it was hard to tell what was going on. So I don't know, I don't remember if I did more around his neck or not. Yeah, so here I'm drying it. And yeah, here's where I get out my color pencil, because I feel like, you know, I can add more detail and stuff with the color pencils. and deepen some of the areas that I wanted deeper. Yep, around the nose, and then that's the black pen and the jelly roll. And the black pen is just a, I guess just a ballpoint pen. But then what I'm using there now is actually a black paint pen. So I have some paint pens in a bag on my desk, and I just happened to grab the black paint pen because I thought that would give me the deepest, darkest black for his nostrils and his eyes. And then I'm going to let that dry for a little bit and then add some highlights to the eyes with the white jelly roll. So here I'm going and adding highlights around the horns. And then, you know, instead of using a white, it's like a tan color, because I felt like that a white might just be too light, and this seemed to really work. And then adding that around in the areas on the animal that's, you know, white, to add a little bit of shadow and contrast. And then again, trying to deepen up some of those areas that I felt should be darker. But yeah, I had a lot of fun drawing and painting this animal. And here, trying to fix those ears. Still not happy with the ears, but... like I said, I decided at some point, yep, it's just going to have to be good enough. And then on his left ear, he's got like white hair in his ear, in the front of his ear. And on the left side, I came too much into that area. Here I'm adding the white jelly roll and some highlights. And so the jelly roll was too thin to cover up where I had gone too far. So I did end up using the white, as you saw there, color pencil to try to fix that, and then the jelly roll. And then again, here are highlights on the mane that's on his back and around, you know, and his mouth and his eyes, and in other areas where I felt like, you know, there need to be some highlights. And then I was going to, here, I grabbed a brown color pencil, and I was just going to kind of deepen up some of the areas, but I really liked the texture it was adding on to the animal, so I ended up going over like all of the brown areas, because I really, like I said, liked the texture it was leaving on this animal. And then here I'm coming in with the lighter, like tan in the areas where it's lighter. And then adding some darker shadows in where there, you know, seem to be darker shadows with the color pencil. And like I said, at this point, I don't know, I just kind of felt like I could sit here and fuss with this thing all day long, you know. So I got to a point where I'm like, you know, at some point you're going to have to call it done, you know. You're going to have to call it done and quit fussing with it. So I did. You'll see that here in just a minute. Here I'm trying to deepen up that shadow underneath and around his neck. And I was trying to with, let's see. Oh, yeah, here's where I try to cover up with the white pen, the background, because I decided, you know what, I don't feel like messing with trying to put in a background. I'm just going to try to fix it and, you know, cover up some of those areas. So, yeah. I just didn't feel like messing with trying to put in a background. So here I figured, okay, I'm done fussing. I'm going to sign it. So I signed it. And then I went and, like I said, went online and like, okay, what exactly is this animal? I need to find out. And then came back and was like, oh no, he has like a mane or a beard or something hanging down. So I found another picture of one. And so I get a better, you know, visual of that mane or whatever that's hanging down under his neck. And decided just to do that with some colored pencils, try to get that in there. So I came back to try to, because I, you know, want to be, you know, as close and correct to the real animal as possible. So yeah, that's what I'm doing here. So anyway, this is pretty much the animal that I did, and this is for my 100-day project. And I'm not doing an animal every day, but, you know, most days I am. I may draw it one day and then, you know, color it the next, like I did with this one. But the idea is to be more consistent with, you know, drawing and painting and creating. So that is, you know, what I'm trying to do. And so I appreciate you stopping by and watching my video. If you like this video and would like to see more, you can give me a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to my channel to see more, or you can leave me a comment. I always enjoy hearing, you know, from people and hearing what they like, you know, what they think and, you know, what they're doing and what they're up to and, you know, what's going on with other people. So, yeah, here I'm just, again, getting into that where I'm just fussing now with this animal and just trying to deepen and hide some of the darker shadows with the colored pencils and going around areas, yeah, where I feel like it needs to be darker. Let's see. Oh, trying to fix the ears again. Not 100% happy, but, you know, it's good enough. Good enough. So thank you for stopping by and watching, and we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.